Have you ever thought about going up in your attic to check to see what your insulation R value is? And when you look up there, you have no idea what you're looking at? Well, I hope this video helps you.
Common insulation materials found in residential attics across the United States include several distinct types, each with unique characteristics. As you look around, remember that the condition of existing insulation plays a crucial role in its effectiveness. When evaluating your existing insulation, you must assign it a rating based on the following guidelines. If you have an attic in poor condition, you should expect to see significant gaps and voids, with missing coverage exceeding 2% of the insulated area. If you have a moderately insulated attic, you may notice missing insulation around wiring, electrical outlets, and plumbing. Overall, the insulation is not up to today's R-value standards, but rarely below 70% of the intended thickness. If your attic is well insulated, then the insulation shows no significant gaps. You should see proper fitting around obstacles and complete coverage around wiring and services. These are the three main types of insulation you will find in residential attics. Once you have figured out the overall condition of your insulation, you can use this to assign an R value based on your type. It is interesting to note how much more forgiving loose cellulose is compared to BATS, meaning it doesn't have to be a perfect install, especially in those tight spots. Cellulose loose fill insulation appears gray and contains visible bits of newspaper. When disturbed, it is notably dustier than other materials. With proper air sealing and ventilation, cellulose is a great solution for attics in most climates. If you find loose fill cellulose insulation in your attic and it is in poor condition, you can assign it an R value of 2.7 per inch. Moderate condition is 3.13 R value per inch. New cellulose is calculated at 3.6 R value per inch. Fiberglass Bat Insulation, famously marketed through Pink Panther commercials, features craft paper or aluminum foil backing on one side. While common, it requires meticulous installation as it's unforgiving of mistakes. New fiberglass bats provide 3.14 R value per inch, but poor installation can significantly reduce effectiveness to as low as 1.26 R value per inch. Most of the attics that I visit with fiberglass bat insulation have an R value of 2.1 per inch. So I would say that is a safe number to use if you have moderate coverage, which means that the insulation is generally in good contact with the ceiling. Loose fill fiberglass presents as white shreds, pink squares, or yellow shreds. Generally, all three yield the same R values per inch. New installations provide 3.14 R value per inch, maintaining this value when well installed, but dropping to 2.36 R value per inch in poor conditions. Moderately covered attics with loose fill fiberglass should be calculated at 2.73 per inch. Now, with a little more information, you can figure out where you stand. Insulation's main role is to resist the transfer of heat. It is responsible for keeping your heat inside during colder months and the heat outside during summer. If you don't have enough, it won't work as well as it should. It is really important to understand where you are now and what you need to get to where you want to be. For an extra tip, don't forget your attic hatch. Here's an easy way to seal and insulate an attic hatch.